We are rolling.
Can't see it, I was manipulated. I had to let her through the door. Oh, I had no thoughts in this. I was the thing she missed. She needed mental talk, so blame it on the night. Don't blame it on me. Don't blame it on me. Blame it on the night. Don't blame it on me.
Hey there, friends. Welcome to Beyond the Trend with Captain Morgan. And today I'm here with a very special guest.
Betsy Birkich of Heavens to Betsy.
Of Heavens to Betsy fame. And so you know that on this channel, I love to support and encourage and work with entrepreneurs. And being one myself, I have a soft spot for kind of the ups and the downs that entrepreneurs go through. So since Labor Day is coming up, we thought it was only appropriate to celebrate all of our hard labor over our businesses with a couple of fun summer cocktails. So we are going to teach you guys how to make three drinks, three separate recipes, and two are actually cocktails, one is a mocktail. But of course, you can change it up however you want. And we have a second DIY, so if you're not too tipsy from the first one, there will actually be how to make these super cute little DIY wine glasses. And it's super easy, super affordable, and my little tag fell off. But anyways, hold on, I'll cut this part
They
out.
Are really fun, and I feel like they're the best hostess gift.
Right.
Just take with a bottle of wine or the ingredients for the drinks.
Ooh, that's a good idea. Mm-hmm. You could almost put this in like a little gift basket mm-hmm. with the ingredients to make whatever's in it. So, also wedding season is still in full swing, so maybe you can use these for a bridal shower or even a wedding itself or
Absolutely.
As a gift to the bride and groom.
So fun.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So stick around, guys. We're gonna have some fun and we're gonna see how these beautiful drinks turn out. And if you want to get some of these awesome ingredients from Betsy herself, Heavens to Betsy is beautiful, all natural, locally sourced preserves and jellies and honey. So all of her contact information is gonna be in the description box down below. Also, we both totally love Instagram. That's another reason why we had to do this, because how Instagrammable are these drinks? So follow us on Instagram and we'll find you guys and like your stuff back. And we just love to connect with other business owners, working women, and anybody who enjoys a good cocktail. So stick around, guys. We hope you enjoy the video and we'll see you in the next clip.
Cheers.
Cheers. I'm super excited about the stuff we're going to actually put in the glasses, but we decided for ease of cleanup that it would be better to do the crafty DIY before the food DIY, I think, right?
Yes.
So we're not getting juices and whatnot out of our space. Okay,
mm-hmm.
So a little pro tip for you at home, okay? Because we're real pro level. We're not. So if we can do this, anybody can do this. So I got these great corkboard labels at Michael's in my local hometown, so really easy to find. And I love these because the corkboard is a little bit different than a blackboard, which of course is always super trendy and fun too. But what's nice about the corkboard is we kind of are going with, you'll see our table setting later, a burlap kind of natural fiber vibe. So I feel like the corkboard kind of blends in with that a little bit more. It's a little bit less harsh. So anyways, all you're gonna do is take a plastic wine glass. I got these for $1 at the dollar store. Can you believe that?
So great.
I know, yeah. So easy.
And they look like they're expensive glass.
Right, you would never even know. Mm-hmm. So, and you know what these are perfect for, right?
Outdoor.
Yes.
The pool,
right? So, okay, so we'll just stick these on at your leisure.
So cute, Morgan.
Do you like it
it's
so
adorable.
Far? Look,
Excellent. We can just stop here. Right? We're done. Easy breezy. So, okay, beautiful. Now, some other fun little things that I got, and we can just kind of mix and match, are ironic mustaches, because what is summer without an ironic mustache, right? So, if you have male guests, they might appreciate that. We have these. Go ahead and hold those up for the camera.
So adorable.
Yeah, just like glittery gold, little extra bling. And you know what I've been noticing this year is that you don't have to be as strict about what metal you're using as long as you're doing metallics at your table. So you can see here, we have some mixed metals going on, silvers and golds and glass and burgundy or burlap and stuff like that. So you can do your guest names, you can do initials, if you're doing like party favors, perhaps the initials of the host or the theme of the party. We also have these super cute little notepads that are gold and white, and they have all kinds of cute little stuff happening on them. So we brought our scissors, and I thought we could cut these up, and then we have thumbtacks, and you can put your little notes and your messages on the cardboard.
So cute. And I especially love this, Morgan. You were saying how we could list the ingredients of the drink
on there. Yeah.
And that's so fun.
Exactly. So then that way, if your friends want, they can take it home and remake the drink anytime. Exactly. And then have wonderful memories of the party that you hosted. And then you'll be everybody's favorite. Isn't that always the goal?
Yes.
So, all right, without further ado, let's get into it, shall we? All right. Are you ready for the big reveal?
Yes.
Okay, so we've completed our first glass, and we will let you at home be the judge of who did it here. Okay, so.
The pressure.
I know, it's intense. Where are those cocktails?
Exactly.
Really should have done those better.
What were we thinking?
Okay, well now we're learning for you guys at home. Okay, so why don't you go ahead and show us what you did for yours.
Voila. I thought it was super cute.
Gold stickers on the corkboard.
Just so simple and elegant. I love that.
And it just so happens they're my initials. So,
sorry.
Yes,
we know whose drink that is.
Right.
And somebody's not sharing, apparently.
Exactly.
Which, once you see how yummy these drinks are, you will totally understand. So, all right, are you ready for mine?
Mm-hmm.
All right, drum roll please. I already feel like I've lost, so.
No.
Be gentle. All right, here we go. Dun, da, da, da.
So cute.
Yay.
It's for the groom. Yeah. So I love an ironic mustache. It's just so cute. So all I did was just put the little tack through the note. But what's fun about these is they're actually sticky on their own. But you know, on a hot summer day, I just think, plus it's a corkboard, so you kind of just need the excuse to use the thumbtack. So, so again, so easy, and you could just do a whole set of however you want and mix and match and kind of use all the little components. And the trick is the pieces are cohesive enough that you really can't get it wrong,
right,
no matter what combination you put it in. So, all right, let's go do another one. Okay. So, we have completed glass number two. Are you ready? The contest continues. So, it's tied up. I don't know what we're gonna do. I don't know who wins. So, if you have a good one and I have a good one, I guess that just means we both have to drink, right?
There you go.
Win-win, okay. Let's see.
So this one, I customized with the initials for Morgan.
Aww.
Yes.
Thank you.
And then, put this one, instead of putting the gold stickers on the corkboard, just did it directly on the glass.
Mm-hmm.
And then on the back side, I put a little sticker on the corkboard that says it's 5 o'clock somewhere.
That's so cute. It's
kind of fun.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Because it totally is. Mm-hmm. Again, just so classic and elegant. I love your style so much.
Thank you.
That's why I love working with this lady. She's a great style inspiration. And I do like my initials on there. And like you were saying, that'll be really fun when you fill it with different drinks and different colors to see how the letters pop. And you can get these letters in, of course, white or black or whatever color you want, and totally customize it to your theme. So just hit the scrapbook section at your Michaels and go to town. All right, so here is my number two. And actually, let's start with the other side. All right, so it a little bit looks like I've already been drinking when I put these on here. I just don't have a surgeon's hand when it comes to application, I guess, but just be with me. I thought it's just kind of like a fun summer thing. And hey, if you're single and you're holding this glass, maybe it's an invitation to somebody across the room. I don't know. So anyway, just cute and fun with the letters. And then on the front side, I put a fun little list of what makes a great summer cocktail. And you can see, let's see, do you want to read it so that they can see?
I'm gonna have to ask you because I need my glasses.
Okay, well, I'll have to turn it around. Okay, yes. So it says sunshine, friends, laughter, beach, vodka, mix well.
Love it.
Yeah.
That's so cute, Morgan.
So just, you know, some of my favorite things for summer. All right. We did decide that the tacks are helpful.
Yeah.
And these are even a little bit big for this. I'm sure you can get little cuter, tinier tacks. I just didn't think to look for them originally, so I just got these tacks at Walmart. But that's basically it. So hit up your local craft store and get some fun little doodads and decorate some plastic glasses and just have a great summer, guys. All right, so we're gonna do three drinks. And the first one that we wanna show you guys is a little bit of a twist on a Greyhound.
Yes.
Right? Okay, so what do we start with for the Greyhound?
Okay, so we're gonna start with the classic ingredients of the grapefruit juice.
Ugh.
I learned about this drink, Morgan, because a good friend and neighbor of mine is into Greyhound rescuing.
Oh.
She rescues Greyhounds down here in Florida that are retired athletes, really professional athletes, these dogs that have had very difficult lives, 3 or 4 years of racing, numerous races, and then if there weren't people like my good friend and neighbor rescuing them, these dogs would be euthanized. So she happens to be getting married on a happy note.
Yay!
To a gentleman. Yeah, that she met through the Rescue Society. They're
That's
both
cool.
Greyhound people. And so she asked me to do a drink for their wedding coming up. So that's what this is, a little dress rehearsal for her Greyhound.
Nice!
Drink.
That's
yeah.
perfect.
Isn't that fun?
Well, I'm glad I get to try it with you.
Yes.
So here, I'll give this to you if you
okay.
want to use glass number one there.
Okay.
All
oops,
right.
oops, oops, oops.
Make a huge mess.
Yeah.
Good thing we have attractive napkins, so.
You can never have too many attractive napkins.
That's so true.
Especially when you make jam.
Mm-hmm.
It gets everywhere.
I'm sure. You are so brave to be wearing all white today.
That's
so
true. You just have to kind of commit and go for it. Okay,
right.
So we're just
so
gonna
we're
go.
We're adding a whole bunch of delicious grapefruit juice.
This grapefruit juice and ice, and then we're going to add a little vodka. You can add gin, you can add vodka, you could probably add rum, but we're going with a beautiful bottle of Genius vodka, which is local to Winter Park.
Ooh.
Genius label. So we thought that would be fun.
Florida gals, we like to support local business. So I'm excited.
Yeah.
I've never tried this before.
This is a locally distilled vodka and with a beautiful peacock on the label. And I just twist it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm strong. I got it.
Okay, you got this.
All right.
5 minutes later.
All right. Okay, all right, so I'm gonna let you pour. I won't be accused of over-serving.
Right, we could measure it, but you just wanna do, I would say, for this size, you know, maybe 2 or 3 ounces.
Do what feels right to you. Just let it come naturally.
Okay.
Okay, perfect.
I think that's enough.
Excellent, okay. So we have that, and now, what's next?
We thought we would do a garnish with an orange and maybe add some cranberries. That's our twist on it.
Beautiful.
Okay.
So And you know, growing up, I used to add cranberry juice to my grapefruit juice sometimes. And so we thought that would be kind of fun to bring that back a little bit. So, Betsy, as the food artist, do you need a toothpick? Want to throw a couple in there?
I thought we just have it kind of floating.
Why not?
And I want to get our glass stir, you know. And
okay. All right. So, beautiful Florida oranges. Look at that. And then, oh, what if we do a little?
Yeah.
Add a couple of these little guys. Okay, well, stay away, Betsy. All right, so, did a little
fun.
Crafty. Yay!
So pretty.
All right, so that is our Florida Greyhound. So easy, but so bright and refreshing. I'm guessing we're going to try it here in just a minute.
So I wanted to get my cute little glass stir and make sure that we stirred this nicely, the Greyhound. It's getting completely stirred. And then Morgan, you had a good idea about these cranberries.
Well, I love mixing, like the more flavor the better. So you could actually skewer the cranberries, just poke a little hole in them like I did on this one with the toothpick. And then that way the juices can seep in a little bit more. Mm-hmm. And if you're mixing this up ahead of time, you can skip adding the ice. So put just the ingredients in, poke some holes in your cranberries and let it all sit in the fridge. And when your guests come over, you can pour it over ice. It'll be extra cold and the flavors will have some time to sink all together. But we're not that patient. So we're gonna go ahead and try a little bit now. The big glasses. They're not the dollar store. Ooh, thank you, ma'am.
Just about perfect for two.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, these little glasses I got in the craft section at Walmart, and I think they were $3 a piece or thereabouts, $3.95. They're actually meant to be a vase, but I thought they were the perfect size for what we're doing. So don't look at how I'm staining my fingers.
Clever.
Oh, look how. Look how pink that got just by me squeezing these two cranberries into it. So if you're a gal who likes a little extra flavor, that's a great idea. And then
and I'm putting my orange right in.
Put your orange right in it. All right, I'll do that too.
So cute.
All right. So excited.
Mm. Actually, quite parched. All this hard work.
All this hard work. So much DIYing. All right. Cheers.
Cheers.
Well, I do too, mm-hmm. So. You know, if this isn't your jam, of course, you could make it a screwdriver and just add orange juice instead, mm-hmm. And then maybe a little lemon or a little lime wedge.
Or I like your idea of cranberry juice.
Straight cranberry juice with the vodka and then add mm-hmm. some garnishes mm-hmm. and things like that. So just play. We just think that citrus and the tartness is a great base to pair with the vodka. And you did really well with the proportions, I feel like. This is a nice blend,
yeah.
So it's not too much. Just good.
Mm-hmm.
And really fresh, so, okay. What if we, I'll just put that over here so that we can gaze upon its beauty. It's so cute. So all right, so one drink down. We ready for number two?
Ready.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what's been trending is putting jams and jellies into your cocktails and mixing different types of fruit and then modeling isn't the right word, right? What do you
styling or you mean garnishing or
well no, but you know when you smash them
oh.
And
with the I know what you're saying.
Right? Like with mojito. Help us out, you guys.
Yeah,
what is that thing called?
The name of that thing. The puree, but it's not a puree. It's in the mold.
Right? Okay, anyways, we'll look that up later. That's what Google is for.
Mold?
So.
Mold?
No, that's different. Mold wine.
Yeah.
That's a thing. That is a word, so it counts.
Something and mortar.
Mortar and pestle.
Yes.
Yes. We figured it out. Okay. We promise we haven't even started.
No.
And just for the record, neither one of us are big drinkers, but we love things that are trending and fresh and experimenting with color and flavor. And both of us are a little bit of foodies, is that fair to say?
Oh, yes.
Yes. Yeah. All right, so we are ready for drink number two. I'm really excited about this one because this takes me back to my younger years when this was kind of the drink to have. And it is our twist on a Bellini. So what all is going in this one, Betsy?
Beautiful homemade peach jam. I really hope that all of your viewers can get their hands on some really good jam because it makes all the difference. This happens to be my jam.
If you live in Florida, you can find Heavens to Betsy jam at many local retailers, including Williams-Sonoma in South Beach. So if you're visiting in town, make sure to pick up some. So, or you can contact her and order your own. But anyway, so we're starting with some peach preserves.
The fresher the better. Okay. Then we're going to just add a little bit. I would say
some ice in here.
I'm going to say about half a cup.
And I'm just eyeballing that. You can see there's nice fresh chunks of peach. This is the next best thing to fresh peaches.
You know, and one of the things I love about Betsy's preserves is they're not heavily sugared. There's definitely no artificial sweeteners and things like that in them. So you know that this is going to make a really fresh drink. And of course, we would encourage anybody to, you know, try and get the best ingredients that you can find or that fit within your budget so that you have a really fresh drink. And even if you're having a little bit more than a sip, you know, you're not putting anything into your body that isn't natural and easy for your body to process.
Exactly, yeah. That's a big part of my mission statement is it's all about fresh ingredients, locally grown as much as possible, and no preservatives or artificial fructose or all that goes bad kinds of sugars.
Awesome, even better, woman after my own heart.
Okay, so we're gonna add some fresh basil, speaking of locally grown herbs and just so fresh. And we're just gonna throw them right in there like that. Because now we're gonna take this, Morgan, and go to my Vitamix that just blends and purees everything like crazy. So
we're gonna have a super yummy blended beverage. Okay, let's do it. Look at that. All right, so this is just ice, peach preserves, and basil, right?
Exactly.
So simple, I love it.
And the aroma smells so good.
Is it really freshness? Mm-hmm. So this recipe actually came about because my friends and I had this cute little apartment where we sat out on the back patio every weekend and we made white wine sangria with peaches and basil, like all soaked and saturated in, and we added simple syrups. But so this is a cleaner, healthier version almost. And now we are going to add the champagne. Mm-hmm. All right, so how much?
I would just go up to about the neck.
That's a lot.
Yeah. That's a lot of peaches in there.
That's true. Good, that looks. So this is a tough job we have, Betsy.
I know, I'm telling you, it's a grind.
Oh, it's a tough life. Kids, one day you can make alcohol on YouTube too.
Okay. Let's add right, a little more. See how that egg settles down. Yum.
Oh, that's gonna be perfect. All right. And I see that you have some beautiful garnishes for this as well.
Yes.
All right, so.
You can use champagne flutes, of course, but
okay.
I like to drink this cocktail out of a wider mouth.
Right, with the,
and with the fresh garnishes.
Ice. Okay, all right, well, let's garnish it then.
Yummy.
Oh my goodness, Betsy.
I know.
So, little warning, this is not a smoothie. So once you start drinking it, do not just drink it down, but it's so fresh and you can taste the basil, but it's not overpowering at all. That is so perfect.
And the ice makes it so slushy and refreshing.
Perfect for a hot summer day, absolutely. All right, well, I guess we have to set these aside because we do have one more drink to do.
Okay.
And this one, we did not forget any of our non-drinking friends. So we have, and of course, any of these can be made as a mocktail. You absolutely don't have to put alcohol in any of these beverages. But we have one more, a glass full of ice. So what is this one
going to be? This one, we're going to do our strawberry infused sparkling water. We thought that would be a fun mocktail.
Yes.
So this is just our strawberry, Heavens to Betsy strawberry jam in all its lusciousness and just frozen overnight in these ice cube trays.
That looks really fresh.
Yeah. And then I'm just gonna scoop it out and put it right in our pitcher here, and we're going to add some sparkling water, and you can add the water of your choice.
Did you find this anywhere special, the rubber
Well, this tray? Actually has its website. Does it say cocktail something?
Cocktail Kingdom, yeah. Apparently, is where you can get, it's a rubber tray, so maybe that's a little easier to get things out of than harder plastic.
And they're nice and large sized.
Yes, only takes a couple. And if you're just, if you pre-make these and you come home and you just want an infused glass at dinner, you could just do one of these, drop straight in the glass, and then you don't even have to go through the whole rest
that's
of the process. So.
Okay, so let's add the sparkling water of your choice.
I got it. I'm using all my muscles. All three of them. Okay. All right. Little Pellegrino. Now, if my husband was here, of course, it would have to be Perrier, as he likes to say. Perrier is his favorite. Okay, here we go. And I love the variety of colors that we're creating too, because again, as a Instagram nerd, that's my favorite thing, and I can't wait to see how these are gonna look on our Instagram account.
This is fun.
Look,
it's just
that
kind of a fun
color,
and it's fun, you know. It's a mocktail, so it's kid friendly too. It would be
absolutely
a whole family event to do this on the back porch.
Your kids would think this is so special,
yeah,
and much healthier than the Sprite.
Exactly.
So you can skip the sodas.
Okay, I think you don't have to mix it up completely. It's kind of good with the chunks of the icy jam in there, but to your liking. Okay, and then we need some fresh glasses, actually.
All right, let's go do that. Oh, look at that.
So much fun.
This is so much fun. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope that you try some of these drinks, and if you do, or if you have any improvements on them, go ahead and either leave a comment or reach out to us on Instagram. Our links are going to be down below in the description box. So thank you guys, and have a wonderful, safe, and happy Labor Day with those you love. Cheers.
Cheers.
Can't be sleeping, keep on waking. Is that the woman next to me? Guilt is burning, inside I'm hurting. This ain't a feeling I can keep. So blame it on me.
Well, thank you again so much for hosting. This was fantastic.
It's great.
So, okay. Yeah, you can cut whenever, honey. We're just
chit-chatting.
Got
this
it.
Is in it?
Yep.
Okay. Ready? Okay.
Yes.
I don't even know. What are we calling this? DIY drinking extravaganza?
Yeah. End of summer.
Oh, hold on, the cat's licking itself in the background.
Oh, great.
It's pretty...
Becky, no!
It's pretty graphic.
Shoo!
that's a pretty good blooper right there.
Just the guy and the cat.
Like those pictures of like engagement photos and a dog's going in the back.
Right.
We were shooting a morning show, and I'll tell you about it after.
Okay.
That happened. The dog was taking a crap in the background, and people were like, "The dog is pooping."
That was the comments.
Yeah, they're like, "Oh my goodness, the dog is pooping." All right.
Here, wait.
I'm gonna reshoot.
So what's been trending is putting jams and jellies into your cocktails and mixing different types of fruits, and then modeling isn't the right word, right? What are you...
Styling? Or, you mean garnishing? Or...
Well, no, but, you know, when you smash them up and...
With the, I know what you're saying.
Right? Like with mojito. Help us out, you guys. Yeah, what is that thing called?
The puree, but it's not a puree. It's in a malt,
Right? Okay, anyways, we'll look that up later. That's what Google is for.
Mold?
So.
Mold? No, that's different.
Mold wine?
Yeah.
That's a thing. That is a word, so it counts.
The something and mortar, you know?
Mortar and pestle.
Yes.